Greetings. I continue to receive the standard Islamic excuse why Allah may commit shirk. But I think my answer this time highlights the root of Islam's excuse. Where is the contradiction here? Allah can swear by anything, because He created everything, but we cannot swear by everything. I'm not critiquing the spelling. My own has flaws as I rush to make comments and videos. Where is the contradiction here? Allah can swear by anything, because He created everything, but we cannot swear by everything. The basic Mohammedan logic is that if Allah made something, He may swear by it. The rationale is Allah is only trying to draw your attention to His greatness. By pointing out to you and drawing your attention to this wonderful thing He made. If Allah made it, He can swear by it. Which seems a little like a child seeking praise for a stick figure drawing. But that analysis is not the focus of this video. The Islamic excuse for Allah committing shirk is that if Allah made it, He may swear by it. And the corollary is that since Allah made all things, Allah can swear by all things. But did Allah make all things? Did Allah make this video? Yes or no? If Allah made this video, then Allah may swear by this video. But that raises a question. If Allah made this video, isn't Allah accusing Himself? Because this video accuses Allah of shirk and Islam of foolishness. And that raises a question. If it is okay for Allah to swear by things He made, why shouldn't we be able to swear by things we made? After all, Allah only swears by things He created to impress us, to show us how great He is, right? So it is okay for you to swear by things you create. This is the example Allah set, and Allah is the best example. So I may swear by my handiwork, and I am behaving just like Allah. I swear by this video that it is the truth. No shirk there because I made this video. I swear by the words I have written. They make sense and I made the statements they form. I swear by the cabinets and drawers I have built. I made them. Allah did not. Allah may not swear by the things I have made. I have to admit, this is kind of fun. I swear by anything and everything I have created. And I am not committing shirk according to Islam's excuse. I swear by the Dagwood sandwich I made last week. Now that was a great sandwich. And I made it, not Allah. Remember, if you made it, you may swear by it. And as I was making this video, the original poster followed up with the expected response. You make your handiwork with the things God created. You didn't create the voice, the image of the video by your own, and your position is not equal to the position of God, who taught you to use the things He created. Above all, God doesn't make sense. I call this the regressive argument. It could also be called the degenerate case. But not because of the negative implication of the word degenerate. It is the degenerate case because the argument seeks to go back to the absolute minimalist position. Allah made the atoms that all things are made from. Therefore, Allah is to be given credit, but never blame, for the results of His atoms, but never blame. Allah must never be blamed for anything in creation, even though He takes credit for all of it. But Christians should not laugh or shout glory too loud before they recognize our own beliefs must address the same issue. This intellectual and moral conflict is one of the most aggressive attacks atheists use against the concept of God in general. But getting back to the poster's comments, he tacitly admits the problem. In his final, seemingly disconnected, statement, "Above all, God doesn't make sins." Think about that. Why did he need to toss that in? Why do you toss in, "Above all, God doesn't make sins"? I'll tell you why, brother. You know the logical problem you have created for your thinking. You are trying to claim Allah created all things, so that Allah can swear by all things. And doing so, you stipulate that Allah created everything that exists. Until you think of something which does not make sense to your argument. Sin. Sin exists. If Allah made everything, then Allah made sin. But that makes your head hurt inside, brother. Think about that. If linear thinking leads you to a conclusion that is impossible or contradictory, the linear way of thinking requires you to re-examine your basic premise. In this case, that Allah created everything. Thankfully, I do not have to solve Islam's problem for Islam. And Christianity does not suffer from the same issue in the same terms. But if you want a video on that topic, let me know. But for now, just realize you can swear by things you made. It's evidently not shirk when Allah does it, so it cannot be shirk when you do it. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.